Felony-friendly employers. Everybody wants a list of felony-friendly employers. The problem is, depending on where you get that list, some lists are more reliable than others. If you were to go to the Career One Stop website, which is run by the Department of Labor, they actually have a page called Workers with a Criminal Conviction. When you go to that page, you click on something like Who's Hiring Felons? They have a letter that says it would be great if a definitive list of felony-friendly employers existed, but it doesn't. So, at least as far as the Department of Labor is concerned, they are in agreement that a lot of these felony-friendly lists are unreliable. So there's different websites out there that claim to have felony-friendly lists, like ranker.com and I think jobsforfelons.org, and there's quite a few. I'm not endorsing any of those, I'm just saying that some of those are more reliable than others. In contrast, back in 2016, the Second Chance Business Pledge Act under the Obama administration, they encouraged employers to reconsider their policies about hiring people with felony convictions. As a result of that, quite a few companies decided to sign on to this list of companies that are felony friendly now, or at least will consider people with a criminal background to work for their organization. One of those companies is Amazon, I think also Google, Georgia Pacific, quite a few huge companies around the nation. That list has continued to grow in the last few years. I think probably the last time I looked at it, like half of them were schools and universities. So I would consider that to be a reliable list because these are companies who signed on to a national letter under the Obama administration saying that they're willing to consider people with a criminal background. So the reliability of lists differs, and I wanted to talk about how to determine whether or not certain lists are reliable. My purpose in doing this is not to discourage anyone. So if you're a family or friend of a loved one who's incarcerated, or if you're incarcerated watching this, I don't want to discourage you. I want to give you more realistic expectations, you know, about what it's like out here in terms of felony-friendly employers. Because a lot of people, they depend on these lists. They start to make their reentry plans based on these lists, and then come to find out some of those companies on there are not, in fact, felony-friendly or willing to work with someone with a criminal conviction. And then you can get deeply discouraged and irritated. And that's the one thing we don't want to happen once you get out of prison, is for you to become discouraged and have a sense of despair. So the first question you want to ask when you come across these lists is, who put that list together? So I've mentioned different organizations, nonprofits, websites, or even the list that you can find online that was begun as a result of the Obama administration. But you want to ask who put that list together. For example, if there's just a list floating around the dare room or being passed around the prison that somebody's, you know, mom or girlfriend or somebody just copy and pasted something off the internet, your family and friends mean well. They want to help you. They want to do whatever they can. But that doesn't mean they necessarily know what lists or websites are accurate and reliable. And so when you see something like this, you want to ask, who put it together? Where did it come from? I've seen lists posted in penitentiary classrooms. The school system itself, or volunteers and chaplains, are putting that up because they want to do whatever they can to help, but they're not questioning where those lists came from or who put them together. So if you see some list, and that's all it is, it doesn't say where it came from, the website, the company, the organization, anything like that, you might want to just take whatever it says with a grain of salt. Secondly, how did those companies get on that list? So the list that was produced under the Obama administration, it's clear why they're on there. These are companies who are willing to say to the nation that they are willing to work with people with criminal convictions. But sometimes on these lists, you might have companies that somebody knows somebody who has a felony and works at that company. And so now that company is on this list. But just because someone with a felony works at a company doesn't mean that company has a policy of working with people with criminal convictions. It could just mean they had a stellar interview. They're related to the general manager. Somehow they got the hookup. There's all sorts of reasons that someone with a criminal history could work at a company, and it doesn't mean that that company is willing to help people with felony backgrounds. Sometimes the criminal background check might take a while to get back, and I've seen this happen quite a bit, is that people get hired on, the criminal background check comes back like a month later, and then they let them go. But you can easily see how people will get the idea that just because someone with a felony works at a given company, they think that means that company is felony friendly. It's not what it means. The third question you want to ask is, when was the list last updated? Things change. Because one company is on this list of felony friendly companies this year doesn't mean that they will be next year. People get, you know, they get a new general manager, policies change, new laws go into effect that prevent companies who otherwise would have hired someone, and now they can't because of some new law. So just because there was a company on that list at some point in time doesn't mean that they're always and forever going to be felony friendly. So when was it last updated? So I keep a list for the people that I serve. And the way that I get those lists is I go to second chance job fairs all around the state of Texas, at least before COVID. And I get business cards and resource pamphlets, and I talk to employers and I put them in a spreadsheet so that I can provide it to those that I serve. But I'm only one person. I don't go and update that call every few months, all the several hundred employers that I have on that list, to find out if they're still a verifiable felony-friendly employer. And I mean well and do what I can. So the point is, not only do you want to know where it came from, but how did they get on that list and when was it last updated? The final question you want to ask is, just because it's a felony-friendly employer or they're on some list of companies that are willing to work with those with a criminal conviction, what does that mean really? How is that defined? What kind of felonies are they excluding? Do they say that somewhere? It's hard enough to get a company to be public about the fact that they're willing to hire people with felonies. It's even harder for them to specify exactly what those are unless you happen to be applying for the job. So there are a couple of crimes that you can imagine would probably be excluded from a lot of companies who do hire those with felonies. So violent crimes or sex offenses are two obvious ones you can imagine a lot of companies might bar from employment. However, it's not always that easy. Sometimes if you try to work like in retail, if you want to go work at JCPenney's or something, they may not hire you if you have like a shoplifting or check fraud or some kind of theft case. The logic there is that if you're willing to shoplift or do some sort of a small-time check fraud, that you'd be willing to do it in their department store. Ultimately, the logic is flawed, but that's just how it goes. If you are trying to get a truck driving job, you may not be able to get insurance if you have like a DWI or vehicular manslaughter or some kind of a felony moving violation. Same thing if you go into the automotive like mechanic industry, sometimes the companies might want to hire you, but their insurance won't insure someone with a moving violation or a vehicle crime like a DWI. Another example out here in Houston is that if you want to work on the ship channel, you have to get what they call a TWIC card. But in order to get that card, some of the criteria involve felonies. There's a group of felonies which permanently bar you from getting that card. And then there's a group of felonies which only temporarily bar you. And there's a certain window of time you have to be away from that conviction. The basic idea is, just because it's on a felony-friendly list, you want to ask, what does that mean? Are there certain crimes that it excludes? I've heard family violence or domestic abuse is also a crime that might prevent you from being able to get a job. So just to recap, there's a lot of questions you want to have about these lists that float around that you see on the internet or that are passed around the day room. But in general, you want to ask at least four questions. Who put the list together? How did those employers get on the list? When was the last time it was updated? And what kind of felonies do they exclude?